Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Lisa Does Science. Today I'm really excited to show you a little selection of slides that I've prepared for you about the cerebellum. So I'll talk to you about this interesting brain structure, its basic anatomy and functions and connectivity. So follow this video if you would like to find out more. The cerebellum in Latin means little brain, and it's actually located behind the brainstem or dorsally of the brainstem here, and the cerebellum on this diagram is depicted in dark grey, just below the occipital lobe here, and cerebral cortex on top here is in light grey, and this plane of this section plane is described as sagittal plane. Here on the right, we have coronal plane of the brain, and you can see the different folia of the cerebellum or lobules. Cerebellum is divided into 9 main lobules that are referred to as folia, like I previously said. And so you can appreciate from this that the anatomy is becoming quite complex. If you want to learn more about it, you can find out more about those 9 different structures. And the major functions of the cerebellum are regarding movement and, most importantly, in controlling balance of the body itself, along with the vestibular system. Cerebellum plays a major role in this. Planning and initiating voluntary movement, as well as motor learning. So, for example, if you're learning a dance or exercise routine, your cerebellum is heavily involved in that. And recently, people are appreciating the function of cerebellum in terms of cognition, language, and speech, which means that we have yet a lot to learn about cerebellum and brain in general. To tell you further about the anatomy of the cerebellum, there is a primary fissure going across here, which divides the cerebellum into 2 major lobes, anterior and posterior lobes. And again, if we look from the coronal plane, we can see that the cerebellar cortex is arranged nicely around the perimeter here, and in deeper structures combined, these are called deep cerebellar nuclei, outlined here. The largest structure is the dentin nucleus. Then we have interposed nucleus and vestigial nucleus. I will tell you about the functions of all of those nuclei towards the end of the talk. Now let's talk about the cerebellar cortex itself. It has very nice and easy to recognize layers. So the 3 main layers are the molecular layer, Purkinje cell layer, and granular cell layer. And depicted here are the cells within the deep cerebellar nuclei. So starting with Purkinje cells, they're the largest neuron type of the human brain. They were first described by Czech scientists called Jan Purkinje in early 19th century. So in fact, the name for the neurons should be pronounced as Purkinje rather than Purkinje, although most English speakers pronounce it as Purkinje. Purkinje neurons have beautiful, extensive dendritic processes that extend to the molecular layer of the cerebellum. And this is called dendritic arborization, from Latin name arbor, meaning tree. Neighboring next to Purkinje cells, you can find Bergman glia that are slightly smaller in size for its soma, with processes extended also in the molecular layer. Bergman glia is a specialized type of glial cells. It's actually related to astrocytes that is only found in the cerebellum. Within the molecular layer, there are also inhibitory cells called basket and stellate cells that control and regulate the activity of Purkinje neurons. Purkinje neurons themselves are also inhibitory, and they dampen down the excitatory signals coming from deep cerebellar nuclei. We also have Golgi cells here that inhibit granule cells, hence the name granular cell layer. Granule cells are very heavily populating this layer of the cerebellar cortex, and they give rise to so-called parallel fibers that excite Purkinje neurons. Other type of fiber that excite Purkinje neurons as well are called climbing fibers. They originate from the inferior olive and medulla, and they excite deep cerebellar nuclei and wrap around those dendritic processes of Purkinje neurons, sending excitatory signals. Motor fibers, on the other hand, originate from all the other cerebellar tracts, and they can excite not only the deep cerebellar nucleus, but also the granule cells. Motor fibers don't form direct synaptic contacts with Purkinje neurons. Instead, they activate granular cells that in turn form synaptic contacts with Purkinje neurons. Let's talk about connections to the cerebellum called afferent fibers. As previously mentioned, climbing fibers originate from olivar cerebellar tract, from the inferior olive and medulla. Then all four other groups give rise to motor fibers. We have corticocerebellar afferents, primarily originating in the motor cortex, but also involving other cortical areas. Vestibular cerebellar and reticular cerebellar afferents originate in brainstem, and spinocerebellar tracts carry sensory information from tendon organs, muscle spindles, as well as touch receptors in the skin or in joints. And that provides all the information cerebellum needs to process and integrate in order to make a decision about initiating and planning movement. And now let's talk about efferents, or the outputs of the cerebellum that carry an effect, that hence the word efferent. And this depends on the deep cerebellar nucleus that the signal originates from. The largest nucleus, or the dentate nucleus, neurons project to the contralateral, meaning on the other side of the brain, ventrolateral thalamus. So ventrolateral thalamus in turn can send signals directly to either primary motor area or the premotor area, and that initiates voluntary movement. Dentate nucleus is also involved in regulation of language and cognition. And neurons located in globose nuclei project mainly into the red nucleus, which is a structure in the basal ganglia, neighboring very famous structure called substantia nigra that is affected in Parkinson's disease. And from the red nucleus, there is a tract of projections called rubrospinal tract. And this helps with regulation and control of proximal limbs for finer movement. And finally, from vestigial nuclei, neurons project to the vestibular nuclei, therefore participating in regulating position of the body in different spatial planes. I hope this introduction to the cerebellum was really useful for you. Please let me know in the comments below what other brain regions you are really interested in learning about. And please support my channel if you can by subscribing and liking the video. I look forward to hearing from you, and thank you very much for your attention. See you in the next one.